If your car's mass airflow sensor is failing, it can cause a variety of problems, including reduced fuel economy, rough idling, and even stalling. Fortunately, replacing the MAF sensor is a fairly straightforward process and can be done in a matter of minutes with the right tools. But what should you do after replacing the MAF sensor? In this video, we'll explore some important steps you should take to ensure your car is running smoothly and efficiently after replacing the MAF sensor. From resetting the check engine light to taking your car for a test drive, we'll cover all the essential post-replacement steps you need to know. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Inspect the installation. It's crucial to verify all of the connections after replacing the MAF sensor. The new sensor might stay loose when you reattach it to the airbox and intake hose, which would be problematic. Additionally, it's crucial to refrain from touching the MAF sensor's element. It is delicate and handling it risks damage. Reset trouble codes. Your car's ECU sent out a diagnostic trouble code to alert you when the mass airflow sensor was malfunctioning. The check engine light would have come on as a result of this process. You must clear the trouble codes in order to turn that light off right away. You can reset the system using your code scanner. The check engine light shouldn't turn back on after the system has been reset unless there is still a problem. Clear data. To properly adjust the air-fuel mixture, the ECU needs to be reset. If you don't do this, the engine may run lean or rich, which indicates an unbalanced mixture. If your code scanner is a high-end model, it can occasionally be simple to force a relearn. Otherwise, you must manually carry out the relearn. Some people decide to unplug the car's battery. The clock settings, seat memory, and radio presets will all be lost if you do this, though. Disconnect for a while before reconnecting everything if you still decide to go ahead with it. Once the battery is connected once more, you should proceed to the following steps. However, depending on the car model, it may take some time for the car to relearn the data with the new MAF sensor. Therefore, manually clearing the data is always the best option. Start the vehicle. The vehicle must be started in order for the relearning process to be finished. Run the engine after turning it on. You can reconnect all of the disconnected features as you proceed to the next step. Change the clock, add new radio presets, and fiddle with any seat memory. When the car battery was unplugged, all of these were erased. Let the vehicle idle for 10 minutes. The car must idle for a while after starting the engine. We advise leaving the car idle for approximately 10 minutes. The ECU is relearning the air-fuel mixture while the engine is idling. This time around, the ride will be much more comfortable. Test drive. You are now prepared to take the car for a drive after finishing the remaining procedures. First, stay close to home in case there is a problem. Turn off the radio so you can hear the engine while driving. You should have a closer look at the sensor once more if the check engine light reappears or if you experience any performance issues. What to do if the problem still occurs? Spending time replacing the mass airflow sensor only to run into problems is discouraging. Given that we did it ourselves, we can relate to your frustration. To help you get back on track, we have created these useful steps. Follow these recommendations whether the check engine light comes on or you experience performance issues. Read trouble codes again. Re-examine and reconnect your OBD2 code scanner. The nearby auto parts shops might be able to read the codes for free if you don't have one. Check a repair manual. You can read about all the suggested steps for replacing an MAF sensor in a factory service manual. You could have connected something incorrectly or made a mistake at any time. Compare your process to the book's description. Many of these details can also be found online by doing a search. Look for technical service bulletins. Each automaker releases technical service bulletins that outline the model's typical problems. Although these bulletins are intended for dealership service departments, anyone may view them. Simply enter your VIN into the search bar on the NHTSA website. Your specific make and model will be listed, along with any recent investigation, service bulletins, and recalls. Contact a professional. When all else fails, it's time to seek professional assistance. Due to their access to more sophisticated diagnostic equipment than you likely have at home, your neighborhood auto repair shop can determine what is wrong. Find a trustworthy mechanic in your area and request a consultation. You might wonder why you didn't just take this route in the first place given the cost of the repair. Hope the information was useful for you. If so, please press like button and subscribe to the channel. If you enjoy our content and would like to support our channel, please consider becoming a sponsor. Your support will help us create even bigger and better videos for you.